Hello and welcome. I'm Çağlayan, Arkan, Global Lead for the Manufacturing and Resources Industry at Microsoft. I am very, very excited about our topic today. Recently, Microsoft launched a new book, The Future Computed AI and Manufacturing, which provides an in-depth look at how artificial intelligence is transforming the manufacturing industry. With me here today is the book's author, Greg Shaw, a prolific writer who co-authored Satya Nadella's very successful Hit Refresh book, among many others. Greg interviewed dozens of customers, policymakers, labor representatives, and other stakeholders from around the world to tell the story behind the impact of AI on manufacturing and the workforce. I am also incredibly pleased to have Nick Tsilas, our senior attorney for manufacturing and growth industries here at Microsoft. Nick will talk to us today about the ethical and regulatory considerations of AI. Welcome to Digital Empowerment. Greg, let's first start with you. The Future Computed AI and Manufacturing is the next book in Microsoft's Future Computed series, which looks at the impact of AI on society. Will you tell us why you decided to focus this next installment on manufacturing specifically?
Well, yeah, first of all, thank you for having me. It was a lot of fun working on this book, doing the research. Manufacturing, if you go back to the very beginning of the Industrial Revolution 250 years ago, which a lot of that was happening in Northern England and in Scotland, you know, the invention of the steam engine, which drove manufacturing for centuries to come, has always been a particular interest of mine, a historical interest of mine. And so I know that manufacturing is always going to be at the leading edge of how technology, the latest technology, is being used. So much of what I see, though, are sort of case studies, sort of, you know, case study by case study. What I really wanted to do was not only look at how manufacturing companies are designing and implementing artificial intelligence, which we should sort of define a little bit. It's the use of data, algorithms, machine learning to do such things as preventative maintenance. I wanted to really understand how companies are designing that, and I wanted to get to know the people behind that.
Essentially, there were six key learnings or themes that came out of your conversations. Can you walk us through each of these, please?
Yeah, the first real finding is that, as I mentioned earlier, manufacturing is leading in the design of artificial intelligence. And I think when you look at these stories in the book, you begin to see, the people who are designing these, they didn't begin as AI engineers. You know, and oftentimes they began as engineers, but they understand their factories, they understand the data, and necessity is behind all innovations. And so these people have become leaders in their field. There is this persistent concern about will AI and digital transformation replace jobs? And certainly there will be disruption and there will be need for transition. Frequently you have these, one person that I interviewed said there's kind of two conversations going on about the workforce. One is a salon conversation, and the other is the factory floor conversation. The salon conversation tends to be sort of intellectualized into, you know, well, what's the future of capitalism? But the factory floor conversation, led by many of these engineers that I talk with, they care a lot about their workforce. They're thinking many steps ahead in terms of how do we get the skills? How do we train this workforce? If they're doing drudgery work now, how do we get them into higher skill, higher value work? And the Future Computed series, I'll just say the third one and maybe transition to Nick, the third of these six is that the future policies, future regulations, you know, do need to be thought through.
Would you like to weigh in, Nick?
Yeah, indeed. The customers and policymakers that we spoke to, as Greg mentioned, were already thinking about the role of policy in shaping the use of AI in manufacturing. A few consistent themes emerged. First theme is the importance of a regulatory regime that fosters confidence in AI, both by those who invest in AI technologies and those who interact with the AI technologies. The second theme that came up was ensuring that there's equitable access to AI, and more importantly, access to the critical data that will fuel AI. We know without data, there is no AI, really. The third theme is capacity building for organizations to leverage AI and for workers who will be working with AI to be trained on the new technologies. The fourth theme is really about collaborative approaches to the creation of new rules, standards, and laws that balance innovation with responsibility in the context of AI. We know that all stakeholders need to come together to develop these new rules and laws. And lastly, encouraging the use of AI to create a more environmentally sustainable supply chain. This is important for manufacturers, and this is important for our planet.
And Charlie, if I could just add on to that, I think the other major finding of the book is that all of these changes require, that a digital transformation requires cultural transformation. Really in every interview that I had, the leaders within these manufacturing companies said, you really do have to spend as much time and effort on bringing your workforce and your company along to understand the truth behind the data, to get their insights and their input into how that data is best used, to be transparent and not to foist this on your workforce, but to bring them along. It'll be a stronger digital transformation if you're changing the culture as well.
These are just brilliant points. I think it is a very, very important junction. It's a historical point that what we're going through, it's a transition. Greg, as we close here, what was the biggest surprise?
Well, it shouldn't have been a surprise. I think most people, including myself, think about the software that Microsoft makes. But Microsoft makes Surface and Xbox and controllers and a variety of pieces of hardware. And so, Microsoft, as a manufacturer, has had to develop some very interesting supply chain and AI technologies. We have some offshore manufacturing that's going on, and there was a real interesting case study for me to sort of see how does headquarters work with the factory to have one source of truth in the data so that everyone's looking at the same information and making the same decisions. I thought it was also interesting and surprising how Microsoft's AI and data is being used to really have a terrific supply chain and understanding that whether reported strikes, a variety of factors can affect a shipment that a retailer is looking for, becoming more precise and more prescriptive with shipments and with manufacturing supply chain. So I thought that was a really interesting story. Shouldn't have been surprising, but it was.
Well, actually, it is surprising for most of my customers, yeah. But I agree with you. Every customer that hears or understands that perspective that Microsoft is a manufacturer and runs a pretty sophisticated supply chain and uses data in a very powerful way wants to learn more.
Yes,
and
well, you gave me that available. Guide, so thank you.
Yes, we make that available to every customer. Yeah. So I'd like to thank you both for the thought-provoking discussion today, as well as putting a lot of effort into making the book happen. It's going to be a vital resource for businesses as they go through their AI journeys. And so I invite everyone to download a free copy today. And thank you very much.
Thanks, Shaw and Nick.